Hey guys, how's it going? I hope you're all doing really well out there. Now, every Friday for the past several years, my wife and I have gone grocery shopping for the upcoming week. And like a lot of people, we keep a shopping list on our refrigerator so that we can add things as we go throughout the week. But sometimes we forget that list on our way out the door, or worse, we get to the store and realize that we can't read what we've written. Well, those are problems that I was able to solve with the app that we're going to take a look at in this video. The problem is that I'm not actually sure how to pronounce the name of the app. I'm not sure if it's Koffan or Koffan, so you may hear me say it different ways throughout this video. The developer has given no pronunciation guides in the description anywhere I can find, so I just got to kind of wing it. So Koffan has solved the problems that I mentioned earlier. Instead of dealing with a paper list that gets lost or forgotten, you can just type out your shopping list in an app and boom, it's just on your phone. Whether you access it through a browser tab or install it as what's called a progressive web app, which we'll talk about in a minute, your list is always with you as long as you've got your phone. Now, before we dive in, I want to throw out just a couple of quick disclaimers, as I have in previous videos. First, this app, as I mentioned, uses Docker for installation. If Docker is not your thing or you're not interested in self-hosting, that's fine. There are plenty of other shopping list apps out there that might fit your needs better, so no judgment here. Second is that I'm not the developer of this app. I'm just someone who found it interesting and wanted to share it with you guys. So if you run into any technical issues, bugs, problems, whatever, I won't be able to help you troubleshoot them nearly as well as the actual developer. So if you run into issues or questions, you'll want to head over to the official GitHub repository that I will have linked in the video description. So with all of that out of the way, let's talk about what makes Koffan interesting. So Koffan is an open source shopping list app built specifically for families and shared households. The idea is that you and whoever you live with, your partner, roommates, family, whatever, can all access the same shopping lists in real time. And what really caught my attention about this app is just how lightweight it is. We're talking about like 16 megs on disk and only a couple of megabytes of RAM when the app is running. For comparison, a lot of web apps out there can easily eat up hundreds of megs of RAM. And the developer actually mentions in the README that they originally built this in Next.js, but it was too resource heavy, so they rewrote the entire thing in Go to make it more efficient. So the app uses Go for the backend with HTMX, AlpineJS, and Tailwind for the front end, and SQLite for the database. It's a really nice modern stack that keeps things fast and responsive. But before we talk about installation, let me actually show you what this thing looks like and what it can do, because honestly, there's no point in going through an installation if you're not even sure that this is what you're looking for. So let's take a look. So here's Koffan up and running. When you first navigate to it, you'll be greeted with a login page and you just enter your password and you're in. One thing that I really do like about the login system in this particular instance is that it's just a single password. There's no complicated user registration, no managing multiple accounts, just one password that everyone in your household shares. This makes it super easy to get everyone on board. Just give them the URL and a password, and they can start using it immediately. So before we jump into the core of the app, we'll click the settings icon in the top right, where you'll find the ability to change between light and dark mode. And you can also change the language to one of several available options, or you can log out. Creating different shopping lists is also very straightforward. Maybe you want one list for your weekly grocery shopping, another for hardware store items, or another for a big party that you're planning. Whatever you need, just create a new list, give it a name, and you're set. So here's a useful thing when you're creating lists. Within each list, you can create sections. So for example, in your grocery list, you might have sections like dairy or vegetable or meat. You get the idea. So this is actually super helpful when you're in the store, because most grocery stores are organized into departments. So you can look at your dairy section, grab everything you need from that area, check it off, and move on to the next section. It keeps your shopping trip organized and efficient instead of running back and forth across the store because your list is all jumbled up. And adding items to your list is quick and easy. Just type in what you need, make sure you've selected the right section, and hit enter or tap add. Items show up in their respective sections immediately, and I really appreciate how easy that is. So when you grab something off the shelf, just tap it to mark it as purchased, and it'll show as checked off so that you or anyone else using the list know that it's been grabbed. There's also this interesting feature where you can mark an item as uncertain. Basically, maybe you can't find it in the store or you're not sure if it's the right thing. This is actually pretty handy when you're shopping and you want to flag something to ask your partner or roommate or whoever, or remind yourself to go back and check on it later. One of the coolest things about Koffan is the real-time synchronization. It uses WebSocket connections. So let's say you're at the store and your partner's at home adding things to the list. You'll see those updates pop up on your phone in real time without needing to refresh anything. And the same is true if you check something off. Everyone sees the updates in real time. So now let's talk about the progressive web app feature that I mentioned earlier. A PWA is basically a web app that you can install on your phone or computer, and it acts kind of like a native app. You don't have to go through an app store, you just install it directly from the website, and this is super, super handy as far as I'm concerned. The nice thing about the developer choosing to make this a PWA instead of building separate iOS and Android apps is that it means that they can stay focused on making the core app better instead of trying to maintain multiple code bases for different platforms. For you as a user, it means you get an app icon on your home screen that launches Koffan, and it can work offline to some degree anyway, depending on what's cached. To install it as a PWA, you just open Koffan in your mobile browser, and your browser should prompt you to add to home screen or install. Do that, and boom, you've got Koffan as an app icon on your phone. Now, the whole interface is designed to be mobile first, which makes sense for a shopping list app. You're probably going to be using this on your phone while you're at the store, so having it work smoothly on a small screen is important, but it also works great on the desktop if you want to sit down and plan your shopping list on a bigger screen. So that's what Koffan looks like in action. It's pretty straightforward, pretty clean, and does exactly what you need it to without a bunch of unnecessary bells and whistles. Now, here's something interesting that I discovered while doing research for this video. When I was looking at the GitHub repository and checking out the contributors, I noticed that Claude AI, yes, the AI assistant, is listed as a contributor to this project. I also found a Reddit post where the developer talked about building this app with Claude's help. So this is what some people might call a vibe-coded app, meaning at least part of the app was developed with AI assistance. And look, I have very mixed feelings about vibe-coded apps. AI tools can be really helpful for development, but I also want to be cautious here and say, if you're going to use any app in your home lab, especially one that has AI-generated code in it, you should really consider doing a code review if you're not 100% comfortable or confident in what it's doing. Look, and that goes with really any app, but particularly when AI is involved in the development process, just please keep that in mind. So with all of that out of the way, if you like what you've seen so far and you want to give this a shot, let's talk about how to get Koffan installed. Since this is Docker-based, the installation is actually pretty straightforward. The GitHub repository provides a couple of different install methods. The simplest way to do this is with a Docker run command that we can see here on our screen. This will pull the image, set your password, map port 80, and create a volume for persistent storage. It's pretty straightforward Docker stuff, but you'd want to change your password to whatever password you want to use when accessing the app. The next option is cloning the repository. And if you do that, there's already a Docker Compose file included. And this is nice if you want to potentially get bleeding edge updates or make customizations to the code before deploying. Again, the Docker Compose for this is pretty straightforward. It builds from the Docker file, maps your ports, sets up the volume for data persistence, and lets you configure environment variables. Personally, I prefer to use Docker Compose files for basically everything running in my home lab. It just makes managing stacks easier, keeps everything better organized, and makes it simple to bring containers up and down as needed. So what I did here was I took that Docker run command from earlier and converted it to a Docker Compose file using a tool called Composerize. You can find Composerize online. It's a free tool that converts Docker run commands into Docker Compose syntax. Now, when you paste that Docker run command into Composerize, you'll get back a clean Docker Compose file that you can use instead. And this lets you use the official image without needing to clone the repo, but still lets you manage everything with Docker Compose. Now, before you deploy, you'll want to take a look at the available environment variables that you can set. I'm not going to necessarily include that in this video, just know that they are there. The reason I don't want to include that in this video is they have a tendency to change as apps mature. So be sure to refer to the official documentation, again, linked in the video description, to deploy this for your needs. Now, I will mention that there are currently, anyway, some rate limiting variables that you can configure to protect against brute force login attempts, but the defaults are probably fine for most people. Once you've got your Docker Compose file set up with your preferred password and settings, you can just run Docker Compose up-d or deploy via Portainer or Dockage or whatever your method, your preferred methods happen to be, and you're good to go. Once you've got Koffan up and running, you can navigate to it in your browser and you'll be greeted with a login page. Just enter the password that you set and you're ready to go. Now, I know that it will come up because of the nature of the app. You can use basically whatever reverse proxy you want to gain access to this remotely. At least at the time of recording this video, there are no environment variables to set with regards to a specific URL, so don't worry about that. Though there is a cookie setting that you may want to change for a little bit of added security. Again, you can just point your reverse proxy to the app, the IP address and the port that you've got this set up on, and you should be able to gain access to it very easily, again, on a remote domain name or VPN or however you like to remotely access your home lab. So that's Koffan, a lightweight self-hosted shopping list that's perfect for families and shared households. It's fast, it's simple, and it does what it needs to without a ton of extra bloat. Now, at this point, I really want to hear from you guys. If you decide to try this, let me know. I'd love to know what you think about it in the comments section. Does it work well? Are there features that you wish it had? What are your thoughts about AI in your home lab? I would definitely love to know that as well. Is AI something that would put you off from adding an app to your home lab with regards to vibe coding an app? Or is it something that you're a little less worried about after a code review? Definitely let me know all of that in the comment section down below. Again, everything that you'll need access to will be in the video description, including ways that you can support the channel, whether it's liking and subscribing, becoming a channel member or a patron. However you want to do that is completely up to you. But I want to thank you guys for spending a few minutes of your day with me here today. And I'll talk to you in the next video.